Hello guys, so a new month and continuing with the series of the current affairs based MCQs. Today is 1st of December 2016 and let's look at today's questions. And so this video series will be presented to you by me, Dipanshu Singh, so you can read more about me on this slide. And you can also follow me on Unacademy to get updates on my courses and on my videos. But most importantly, do rate, review and recommend these videos. And general instructions being the same, watch today's Hindu summary before or after attempting the questions. And do pause the video if you feel like while attempting the questions, and share your score without fail in the comment sections below to assess your preparations level. So the first question is regarding the following statements for the National Anthem of India. Not singing the National Anthem is punishable under the Prevention of Insults to Nation Honor Act of 1971. And Article 51A contains the provisions related to the National Anthem. And the National Anthem first sung in India was first sung in India in the 1911 Calcutta Indian National Congress sessions. So which of the following is are correct? So the second is correct, that it comes under the Article 51A of the Constitution of India, and the National Anthem was first sung in India in the 1911 Calcutta INC session as well. However, not singing the National Anthem is punishable, but you know, creating problems while somebody singing it and intentionally prevent the singing of the Indian National Anthem or causing disturbance is a punishable offense under that act. So A, the first one statement is not that correct, it's partially correct. So second and third only is the correct options. So B, second and third is the correct answer. And the next one is regarding Cyclone Nada. So it is expected to bring showers to Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. It originated in the Bay of Bengal, and cyclone warnings for Nada have been given by the Cyclone Warnings Services Department of the Indian Meteorological Department. So which of the following is are correct? So the second one is correct, that it originated in the Bay of Bengal and the warnings have been given by the IMD. But it's expected to make a landfall near Puducherry and the coast of Tamil Nadu, not in Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. So first statement is incorrect. B, second and third only is the correct option. The next one is regarding the recent liberalization of the visa regime in India. So incremental changes in the visa policy have been decided by the Ministry of Home Affairs and were recommended to the cabinet. An approved merger of existing tourist, business, medical and conference visa categories to make one comprehensive long-term multiple entry visa. And this is expected to stimulate economic growth, increase earnings from the export of services. So all of the three statements are correct. This is in news in today's Hindu as well. So do go through the Hindu summaries for today as well as the newspapers to read more about it. So all the statements are correct. And the next question is regarding the recent report on decline in sex ratio. So it talks about the fall in sex ratio of females per 1,000 males in the entire population. The ratio has fallen from 898 per 1,000 in 2013 to 887 per 1,000 in 2014. And the data was from the sample registration system released by the Office of the Registrar General of India. So which of the following is are correct? So actually, only second statement is incorrect. The rest of them are incorrect, because the data has provided, it talks about the fall in sex ratio of, you know, the decline in sex ratio at birth, not specifically female. And the data was provided from the civil registration system released by the Office of the Registrar General of India. And that is why the first and third statements are incorrect. Only C, the second one, is the correct option. And the next one is regarding the central OBC list. So cabinet has approved the changes in the central OBC list, and the National Commission for Backward Classes recommends the changes in the OBC list, and the advice of the NCBC is not binding upon the central government. So the first and second statements are correct. The third is incorrect, because it is you know, shall ordinarily be binding upon the central government of India. So therefore, A, first and second only is the correct option, third being the incorrect one. And now, match of the following of the list of intangible cultural heritage and their countries. So Rumba dance, Bulgaria, Cossack songs, Ukraine, and Madibol Arab music and dance it from Portugal. So the second statement is correct. First and third are incorrect. C, second only is the correct option. Rumba dance is actually from Cuba, and Madibol music dance is from Uganda. And this is in news today, very important. Do go through the Hindu summary for today and newspaper. Very important for your GS1 and even prelims as well. And the next one is regarding the Kigali Agreement. So it deals with the conservation of wetlands and the resources. or it deals with the control of transboundary movements of hazardous wastes and their disposal, or it is an agreement that guides the future sustainable development around the world, or D, none of the above. So as you know, it deals with the hydrofluorocarbons, so D, none of the above is the correct answer for this one, and they deal with the phasing out of HFCs, and the cabinet has approved their negotiating position adopted by the government at the meeting of parties to the Montreal Protocol of Vienna Convention for Protection of Ozone Layer held at Kigali in Rwanda. Now, the next one is regarding the following statements related to the Whistleblowers Protection Amendment Bill 2015 passed in the Lok Sabha. So it prohibits disclosures prejudicially affecting the sovereignty and the integrity of India, and it amends the Whistleblowers Protection Act 2014, and the disclosures can be made even if they are prohibited under the Official Secrets Act of 1923. So which of the following are correct? So the third statement is actually incorrect, because the disclosures are prohibited under the Official Secrets Act of 1923. The rest of the two statements are correct, because it prohibits disclosures affecting the sovereignty and integrity of India, and it does amend the Whistleblowers Protection Act of 2014. So that is why A, first and second only are the correct statements. So that is the correct option, and the third is incorrect. The next question is regarding the recent howitzers defense deal, and it is a government-to-government deal. It is the third defense deal to buy artillery guns after the Beaufort scandal, and it has deal done with the USA. So the first and third statement are actually correct, and the second one is incorrect, because it's the second deal, the second major military deal for you know, artillery guns after the Beaufort scandal, not the third one. So that is why only first and third are the correct options, and second one being the incorrect. And the last question for today is, which of the following areas did Jagdish Chandra Bose work in? Emancipation of women in India, study of radio microwaves, elimination of untouchability in India, and civil engineering. So, very famous person. You should know details about him. One of the geniuses of India. So, he worked on the study of radio microwaves. And IEEE named him one of the fathers of radio science. And his 150th birthday was recently celebrated by the government. So, this is it for today, guys. Do practice your questions well. Do prepare well. And all the best for upcoming mains examinations for the aspirants. And people who are preparing for next year prelims, do practice your questions properly, revise your stuff properly, and do mention your scores in the comment sections below. So thank you and have a good day.